So apparently I just decided not to record an intro for this video, which is really weird. I'm editing it like a month later, so I'm just sat here like, what the fuck? But anyways, this is Five Nights at Freddy's makeup look. It's Freddy Fazbear himself. Fucking hell. Let's just get right into this. This is part of our Halloween series, so that's pretty sick. And this is also in hype of the FNAF movie. Let me know if you guys are seeing it. I'm going straight off to Comic Con, so that will be fun. Right, guys. So to start this look off, I'm going in by just getting all my hair out of the way with a bald cap, spraying that down with some Got To Be, cutting the edges, and just leaving that to set. And then I get into a little bit of a fight with the contact lens. This is what you get for buying cheap contact lenses. Don't do it. Then I'm just going around my whole head with some Saran Wrap, cutting that down to size. And this is just going to create a little barrier to extend our head out and just create that really cool bald look, I guess. Then I'm just going around my head with a really thick layer of cotton and latex, just covering everything and extending that down to my jaw, using that to bring out my cheeks. And this is how we're actually going to build up our look. This was predominantly a cotton tissue and latex look. So I'm bringing that up just to sink my eyes in a lot as well. And by building this really thick layer, I was actually able to take this off afterwards and keep it as a mask. But fun fact, it was actually extra thick around my nose because I just basically had to go for a little bit of a Voldemort look and just completely get rid of my nose. Because where Freddy has that bear nose, he doesn't have a human nose, so I just had to get rid of my human nose shape. So there was like a couple of inches of cotton and latex on my face at this point. It was at this point I started to lose hope a little bit because I was like, oh god, why am I doing this to myself? But I just started to build up where my jaw would be at this point, and I was just like, let's get the bigger parts out the way and we can do any little infills after. But then I actually realized, oh, my nose still isn't covered enough, so I put more on, and here I am actually putting in that bare nose, and I'm just using layers of latex until I'm happy with the size and how far it comes out. Now I'm just building out that mouthpiece again. This was one of the trickier pieces where it had to come out so far. Now, if I was an actual FX artist, I probably would have built this on advance and just glued it to my face. That's fine, I had 4 hours to kill. I think I actually ended up using a whole thing of tissue and a whole bag of cotton balls to do this look. So that's a fun fact. And at this point, it's actually looking very reminiscent of my Grinch look. And so far, this would just be a Grinch tutorial. And now we're finally building that mouth out more. This is where most of the tissue was used, just to extend that mouth and stop us looking like Grinch. It looks a bit like a duck bill at this point with only the top half on, but it actually looks so sick. Like, just looking back at us, I'm like, god damn, I did that. So we're just getting it on at this point, still looking like a duck bill, just pulling that jaw out as best as we can, coating it in lots of cotton and latex, keep it nice and strong. And then we're just kind of just adding in lots of little strength points. Here I was adding like a centerpiece in the nose that I noticed Freddy has, where it's like, where their nose dips in the middle a bit. At this point, though, my hands were so coated in latex, getting any little finicky details done was just such a nightmare. I was dreading it so bad. I'm just adding more and more cotton and latex and just building this look up. So next up, I was just going in with some glue, covering my eyebrows, and then I was just going over with some more cotton and latex, just completely getting rid of my eyebrows. Freddy Fazbear doesn't have eyebrows. Freddy Fazbear doesn't need eyebrows. And I'm just completely covering around my eye, leaving a small little sneak peek bit. And that's just one of the creepier things of this look as well. The eyes ended up looking so sunken where I'd built up the latex so high. Here I am doing the other eye. They didn't end up matching, and I did fix that to the best of my abilities. But it just kind of makes it look more decrepit, which I think actually added to a little bit of creepiness. This was actually a very forgiving process because of how wet everything was. So much took a while to dry. There I am building up that bottom jaw piece again. Similar again, duck bill method. So I'd put a piece on, cover it in latex, put another piece on, add some latex. Now, I wasn't completely saturating this in latex. I was adding little bits as it dried. And that was actually what let it have the stability that it did. And it still stayed together today. I'm looking at it on my shelf currently as I do this voiceover. Now I'm just going in with some black watercolor on a brush and just doing around my eyes and my lips. And I'm just really making sure to get rid of those features and sink them in. And this will just allow everything else to highlight. Then I actually cut out where I wanted the head the end, and I just completely filled that in with the black again. I dead ass just rubbed the paint on my head just to get rid of it, doing some neck work, and this took a little while, but it wasn't too bad. Next up, I'm going in with a brown. It took a while to find the right shade of watercolor brown, I think I got that in the end, and here I am just coating the face completely. At this point, it just starts to look so fucking creepy and psychotic. I'm actually in love with it. The hardest part was when the paint dried, it had a really tacky sheen to it, and I wanted it to be slightly more matte. So I just had to completely destroy like three brushes in one of my eyeshadows to actually get that down. But here I am just completely covering all that those latex spots, and it actually went pretty well. And this process took about 40 minutes, I'd say, which for this kind of look isn't too bad. My ears were also fully covered at this point, so I was trying to watch The Office, but I could barely hear. I'm going back in with some of that black watercolor on the nose just to completely fill that in. And then I'm just doing any little touch-ups. I added in some paper ears I'd made. Didn't make much of a difference, but they did the job. And then I'm doing that inner jaw with that black just to add some depth to it. I'm doing the same to the top jaw. Now I'm just going in with some black eyeshadow on those inner spots, anywhere I want to add some shadings, and just matting everything down a little bit. Here I am using some lash glue to put in the teeth. These were just cut out of paper and they held up to this day. I used a card paper though because it held up a little bit better. You could probably get away with basic printer paper, it just wouldn't hold up as long term. And here, like I said, I'm going in with that eyeshadow and just trying to mattify the whole look. And this added a lot more of the warm tones because, as you could see, the look was looking a little bit coppery. So I just went all over my face. I actually used my finger at one point as well just to get a thicker coat on, and this got us from like that metallic brown to more of like a warm chocolate brown, like Freddie actually is. So I just got that all over my face. And here we are, just mixing up a little bit of blood to go on the teeth. This was one of my favorite parts actually, because it was so fun. Once I had that blood mixed, I went in with a toothbrush and I was just like flicking it on.
So the makeup is all done. It's definitely not perfect, but it's pretty cool, I must say, like with the hat. So I'm gonna go get some photos, and you guys are coming with me. Eating cheese like it's children's hair.
What do you think of my makeup?
I think you're very disturbed, just like your makeup is.
So this is fun. We saw one person and I almost started crying with how much I was laughing.
And it is 12:30 in the morning. People coming out of nightclubs and bars.
Our timing is, honest God, impeccable.
As always.
Can't wait to do this look for the FNAF film.
We're gonna start gaslighting people when they ask about your face.
So someone literally yelled over, "What's happening?" We were like, he's like, "Mask, scary." And we were like, "Yeah." The thing is, me and my mom are equally autistic, so we don't know how to socialize. I'm just gonna carry on recording while I walk, because I know something's gonna happen. I saw a child, which I felt really bad about.
There are a lot of children out for this time of night.
I purposely leave this shit till late at night because I don't want to like creep people out, especially kids. Drunk people, it's fine to fuck with kids. There's a moral line. Oh God, I lost the tooth. Thing is, I can barely hear, so anyone says anything, I'm relying
I
on
can
her.
Barely hear. I've got a double ear infection.
Oh, we're fucked.
Oh good, and now we come to the place with the bars.
So pulling up to local cemetery, gonna take some pics. We're ganking. Oh my God. Oh God, that lighting.
I just wanted to stay in bed and sleep. I hate your problem for not getting up.
Kira was meant to come with me originally because 2 6-foot fuck off goths are less likely to get shit. But he's asleep, so fuck you, my guy.
Cheers, kid.
Oh god, this is gonna be shown in a court.
Why is it fair all they join breaking? Okay, so that entrance is locked.
We gotta go to the one further down.
I'm not climbing walls.
Creepy cemetery time. Oh god. I feel like this church purely needs to exist near me to counteract the fuckeries that are my existence.
It's exactly our first time, is it?
No, it's not.
Disrespectful when going into a church.
Oh yeah, just with me. We're only going there to take photos. So I'm saying this and I know I'm probably gonna curse it. It's kind of hard when it's late at night to be scared of anything else, because it's kind of like a top of the food chain moment right now.
I'm scared that I'm gonna get arrested and I'm going to have to explain this to my employer.
We won't get arrested, it's public property. So yeah, let's take some pictures. So there's this really cool graffiti wall near us. You can kind of see it in the background, and we were taking a photo there, and like two people on motorbikes just pulled the fuck up.
It's now coming up to 1 a.m. People are still coming out of pubs and bars.
Somehow.
Amazing.
This is fun.
It's never a dull moment.
I love just the full, like, the people's, like, the full 360 of this shit.
This is the... I mean, be fair.
I'd think it's cool personally.
I know, but I'd still probably double take myself. Like, I understand why people are like...
The fuck?
The fuck?
Just trying to walk home without any shit.
That'd be nice.
Without any fuckeries.
Without any Grinch-type incidents.
Grinchgate.
Grinchgate. Why do I enable this shit?
Because you were doing worse at my age.
Probably
too. Hear me out. You're walking home from the pub at 1 a.m. You're drunk as fuck and you just see this. What are you doing? Is there a correct answer to that question? Probably not. My little top hat just vibing.
Oh. I don't want her to give you first aid while
I'm doing this thing. We just almost saw a drunk person fall over.
Please, not the time.
Tis not.
Oh, hi. You want friendship? You want friendship.
This look was one of the most challenging looks I've done in a while, and one of the first looks I've done in a while. So at first I was like, wow, this doesn't look perfect, I'm a little upset. But I kind of grown to love it as like a realistic horror adaptation. Jigglypuff. Who's that Pokemon? It's Jigglypuff. It's like... Hear me out. It's like a very... You know the Winnie the Pooh horror movie that came out? I took inspiration from that for the look. To make like a realistic horror Freddy. And it's not that bad, I don't think. I really like it. So I'm proud and we can only grow from here. I love you guys so much. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.